Airway hyperresponsiveness is a state in which the airways of the lungs become constricted in response to nonspecific stimuli. We created this video to cover the medical definition and provide a quick overview of this topic. So, if you're ready, let's get into it. Airway hyperresponsiveness is a key characteristic in patients with asthma. As I mentioned, it's a term that refers to excessive narrowing in the airways of the lungs that occurs in response to stimuli that would otherwise have little or no effect on healthy individuals. These stimuli are often referred to as triggers because they can cause an acute episode to occur in patients with asthma. Here are some examples: pollen, grass, dust, smoke, mold, pollution, pests, cleaning supply chemicals, pet dander, and fragrances. Other things, such as physical exercise and even breathing in cold air, can trigger an episode as well. Keep in mind that each patient is affected differently by each trigger, and in general, they should strive to avoid them as much as possible. When airway hyperresponsiveness takes place, the patient may show the following signs and symptoms: chest tightness, wheezing, difficulty breathing, coughing, shortness of breath, pursed lip breathing, increased accessory muscle usage, and diaphoresis. Asthma is a disease that is chronic, obstructive, inflammatory, and varies with different levels of severity. A severe episode may be life-threatening and require intubation and mechanical ventilation. Airway hyperresponsiveness with asthma is known to be a reversible condition because the obstructed airways can be reversed with certain medications and treatment methods. Again, for this video, we just wanted to cover the medical definition and provide a brief overview of this topic. We'll be breaking it down into much more detail in a separate video. Real quick, guys, do me a huge favor and hit the like button. It really helps support the channel and I greatly, greatly appreciate it. And while you're down there, go ahead and click the subscribe button as well, because we have a ton of other videos on our channel that I think you will enjoy. Just a quick reminder, we are not doctors. This video is for educational and informational purposes only. And if you want to dive deeper and learn more about this topic, you can go to respiratorytherapyzone.com, where we have a ton of free study guides, practice questions, and other helpful resources. I'll drop links to everything you need right below this video down in the description. Thank you so much for watching all the way to the end. Have a blessed day, and as always, breathe easy, my friend.